I'm Alex, and welcome to Super Make Something. Today, we're making amazing resin 3D printing time lapses using computer vision, machine learning, and the Elegoo Mars 3. Let's get started. Magical looking time lapses are all over 3D printing social media these days. From manually shooting a series of photos using an intervalometer to the Octolapse Octoprint plugin, several methods exist to create awesome videos of your FDM prints. The mechanics of how the build platform moves for resin printers has made it difficult to make similar time lapses for MSLE machines until recently. Resin Lapse is a DSLR camera add-on developed by YouTubers Uncle Jesse and Andrew Sink, which plugs into Canon cameras and acts as a remote trigger. By using a photoresistor to sense UV light that spills out of a printer's enclosure when a layer is being exposed, Resin Lapse is able to trigger Canon DSLRs using an analog signal that is sent to a camera through its 2.5mm TSR input jack. Unfortunately, I don't own a Canon camera, making it impossible for me to use this add-on to make my own time lapses. While I'm sure that Resin Lapse cables for different camera models will be released eventually, I realize that it should be possible to create a very similar result that works for any camera and that doesn't require any special add-ons using a bit of computer vision, Python programming, and machine learning. The requirement for any good-looking 3D printing time-lapse is that the lighting conditions need to be kept consistent for all photos in the sequence. Because of this, it should be impossible to tell in which order photos were taken. That is exactly what we're going to exploit to create this time-lapse only using software. In Resin Lapse time-lapses, the print bed consistently moves upward to make it seem like the model is being pulled out of a printer's resin vat in one continuous motion. Therefore, if it's impossible to tell when a photo was taken, recreating this effect should be as simple as rearranging photos taken during printing into the correct order to make it look like the print bed is always moving upward. To test this method, Elegoo sent me their new Mars 3, a masked stereolithography or MSLA printer with a 4K monochrome LCD screen, an upgraded lighting and heatsink system, and a new, stylish curved exterior. Retailing for $300, this printer is able to create models with an XY resolution of 0.035 millimeters or 35 microns, making it perfect for creating tiny, yet highly detailed prints. The overall setup procedure has remained essentially identical for all of the printers in Elegoo's Mars line, so if you're interested in learning more about this or the MSLA printing process in general, please click the link in the top right corner of the screen to check out my previous videos on this topic. To rearrange the photos in the correct order, it's necessary to be able to measure the position of the print bed in each of the photos. To do this, I first headed into CAD and modeled an enclosure for an LED throwy, a simple circuit that literally consists only of an LED and a CR2032 watch battery. In this design, the enclosure sandwiches the LED leads to the watch battery, causing the LED to light up. The LED's light is then diffused by a small sphere printed out of clear PLA, which shows up in each of the photos captured for the time lapse as a uniformly lit circle. I printed each of the components, assembled everything with a few M3 screws, and then taped the throwy enclosure to the top of the Mars 3's build plate screw with some double-sided tape. After this, I headed into my garage and set up my lighting and cameras. Since the lighting needs to be consistent throughout the entire printing process, and time-lapse photos need to be recorded with the printer's lid off, I found that my garage was the perfect place to carefully control lighting while avoiding hazardous resin fumes. For time lapses, I typically use my Nikon D3100 DSLR in conjunction with an intervalometer that I can use to automatically take pictures after a specified amount of time. Newer cameras, like Sony's A6400, often have internal intervalometers that can be accessed through their menus, so you may not even need any extra accessories depending on your make and model of camera. After setting the picture interval to 15 seconds, I next started the print and let the Mars 3 do its thing. Once the print had finished several hours later, I opened Python code that I had written previously to process each of the images. After installing the required libraries, I transferred all of my photos into the Frames folder located in the root directory of the code and got ready to create my time-lapse. It was now time to process each of the images and rearrange them into the correct order, which is where the LED throwy comes into play. By extracting the location of the lit circle in each of the images and then sorting the order of the photos so that the circle's Y location always moves up, it's possible to create an image sequence that looks like the print is being pulled out of the vat in one continuous motion. Circle locations are identified using the circle huff transform, an image processing method that uses edge detection to find and extract circles with a user-specified radius in still images. For more information on how this method works, Be sure to check out the video How Circle Huff Transform Works by YouTuber Thales Senkorting, which is linked in the video description below. In our application, we know that the lit LED will always travel along the z-axis of the printer. This allows us to further constrain the problem by only looking in a specific region of interest in the image, which helps to eliminate false positives and also makes image processing a bit faster, since each photo in the sequence is a 14 megapixel image with over 14,100,000 pixels. After selecting the region of interest with a mouse, the code then iterates through each of the folders in the frames directory and saves the XY location for each circle it found, along with its corresponding file name, into an array. After this, rows of the array are sorted so that the Y location of the circle always increases, leading to a sequence of images that makes it look like the print bed never moves down. Unfortunately, there's a bit of an issue. Because a picture is taken every 15 seconds, it's likely that the location of identified circles in several images will be the same, which would make it look like the print bed is pausing as it travels up the z-axis. To account for this, the code only keeps the first image at each circle Y location and deletes the rest, since it will again not be possible to tell exactly when a photo was taken if the lighting conditions within the time-lapse sequence are kept the same. Overall, this sequence already looks pretty good. The camera seemed to capture at least one photo for many of the circle's pixel locations along the printer's z-axis, so at this point, we could simply take each of the photos, drop it into our favorite video editing software, and create our time-lapse as usual. But, seeing as we already have some working Python code, let's get a little extra. Frame interpolation is a video processing technique that allows artificial video frames to be created that were not actually recorded by the camera. Historically, this technique has been used to create fake slow motion video from footage that was not taken with a high-speed camera, or to create a smooth animation from a relatively low number of keyframes. In our time-lapse application, we will be using it for a slightly different purpose. Since the camera's intervalometer blindly takes a photo every 15 seconds, it's possible that it may not capture a photo for every Y location of the LED marker. This then results in a time-lapse where the build plate's motion is not smooth, which can be a bit jarring and make the video seem jerky. Frame interpolation essentially allows us to generate photos that were not captured and fill in any missing frames, resulting in a smooth time-lapse even though we did not capture a photo for every frame in the time-lapse sequence. The most straightforward way of interpolating frames is to simply average neighboring frames together in order to create a new one. Unfortunately, this creates a ghosting effect and results in noticeably blurry images. Instead, more sophisticated frame interpolation methods use a technique called optical flow, which estimates how pixels and objects move between frames, and then propagates these pixel values accordingly to create new frames without any blurring. RIF, or Real-Time Intermediate Flow Estimation, is a technique developed by researchers at McGee and Peking University that uses neural networks to accurately estimate optical flows at arbitrarily small timescales between frames. In practice, this allows video shot at standard movie frame rates to be slowed down to 1/16th of their speed or less without any noticeable artifacting or graphical glitches. While the details of how exactly RIF works are a bit outside of the scope of this video, be sure to check out my Machine Learning 101 Intro to Neural Networks episode, which explains the basics of what neural networks are and how you can implement one yourself from scratch. In our code, we first identify missing frames in our image sequence by looking for places where the pixel position of identified circles between neighboring frames is greater than a user-specified threshold. The size of this gap is proportional to the number of frames that we would like to generate, which is then passed to the RIF interpolation method as the desired slowdown factor of our video. At this point, our photos are still at their original 14 megapixel resolution, since this will allow us to crop and pan in our final 1080p time-lapse sequence without losing any detail, so calculating the optical flows and generating new frames can take a while. Once new frames are generated, the final sequence with all images is written to the output folder in the root directory of the code, at which point it's time to drop the sequence into your video editor of choice, perform any color correction, panning, cropping, and zooming, and generate your time-lapse as usual. Let's see what the final time-lapse looks like. Overall, the time-lapse looks pretty good. With some basic computer vision and machine learning, This method is able to produce high-quality time-lapses that are sure to be a hit on social media. While we're using Rife in this project to fill in missing video frames, this method can be used for a variety of other purposes too. For example, I used it in a few sequences in this video to create smoother B-roll footage. See if you can spot where I used it and drop a timecode in the comments below. A big thank you to Elegoo for sending the Mars 3 to me in order to make this video. It's a fantastic machine that can create highly accurate models at a great price. The washing and curing machines in their new Mercury X bundle are also great pieces of hardware that allowed me to clean and cure my prints with significantly less mess, material waste, and time. In case you're interested in picking up any of these machines for yourself, be sure to check out the links in the video description below. The code for this project is available for free on GitHub so that anyone can use it to make their own resin 3D printing time lapses. If you like this project and found it useful, please consider giving it a like, subscribing to the channel, and hitting that bell icon to be notified when I upload my next video. If you end up using the code from this episode to make your own resin 3D printing time lapses, please consider becoming a patron on Patreon to help me make more episodes like this in the future. Your support ensures that Super Make Something episodes will always remain free and open source to anyone looking to learn more about 3D printing, programming, AI, and more. To stay up to date on my latest episodes, be sure to follow me on social media, where I post behind-the-scenes updates while I'm working on a project. Finally, please be sure to tag me in posts where you use the software for yourself. I'd love to see what you come up with. Well, that's all there is to this episode. Thanks for watching. Now go super make something.